You're watching the fastest growing local news station. This is WPBF 25 News at 6.
Well, this is not what we call a pill mill. This is a medical office, and I treat the patients as a patient appropriately with the best medical care possible.
A pain clinic doctor defends his line of work one day after the county vows to crack down on this booming business. Good evening. I'm Tiffany Kenny.
I'm Victor Blackwell. Thanks for joining us. Now, while this doctor agrees that more needs to be done to weed out the bad operations, he's worried about the troubles ahead for legitimate patients.
Investigative reporter Terry Parker first brought this exclusive story that prompted action that the Palm Beach County Commission took, and she joins us now with more. Terry?
Well, so many pain clinics are popping up in Palm Beach County that even some of the pain clinic operators themselves are worried. They agree unscrupulous people just out to make easy money are getting in on the action and are giving out these addictive pills too easily. But they're also worried that this new moratorium and resulting regulations could hurt the legitimate clinics and patients.
Dr. Christopher Heller is an anesthesiologist who runs this pain clinic in Lake Worth. He says he is upset at the rising number of competing clinics that are irresponsibly prescribing large amounts of addictive pain pills.
So unfortunately, I find a lot of patients that come to me from other clinics on exorbitant amount of medication, so I have to very gradually lower their doses to prevent them from going through acute withdrawal syndrome.
Heller's also concerned about Palm Beach County's new moratorium on pain clinics. He says lawmakers might make it too hard for responsible clinics to operate.
I'm concerned that this will have a deleterious effect on patients who really need pain medication, and they'll be afraid to seek good health care and good medical care.
Heller says he takes precautions to keep doctor shopping addicts out of his clinic. Patients must be over 23, have an in-state license, and he requires random urinalysis to make sure patients are taking only the drugs they are prescribed.
They took bold action, and what they did will actually save lives.
Jupiter Father James McGilvery is elated the moratorium passed. Since we profiled his story last month about his pill-addicted son, McGilvery and hundreds of other viewers have been emailing the county commission demanding action on pain clinics. County Commissioner Karen Marcus says she was surprised to hear how much devastation pill addiction was causing local families. And because of our stories and the emails, she proposed the moratorium.
Terry, I was elated, and I want to thank you. I want to thank Karen Marcus. I especially want to thank the over 250 people that have emailed me with their sad story.
And I've gotten those emails as well from parents who say their children and relatives have gotten hooked on these pills and ruined their lives or even overdosed and died. They blame the easy access and are demanding action. The county commission says it will study the problem and come up with some tighter regulations surrounding these clinics.
Well, Terry, what type of regulations are they considering?
Well, maybe ensuring that a licensed doctor is on site prescribing the medication, limiting the amount of pills they can prescribe, and also requiring that these clinics be owned by doctors, not by people with no medical background, but as some of the clinics currently are.
All right, Terry, thank you.